Students have often shared over the years that they would love to engage more with te reo Māori, but they were nervous, or they didn't feel that they had the support in their hands to enable them to share the language in everyday, real ways with young children. So this resource was designed to gift confidence and encourage te reo Māori learning alongside children.
This was very much inspired by our students. I really heard the need, the cry for help in terms of Māori language in practice. Working with students in class and on block courses, I've developed small resources along the way to support them. So a lot of what's in the resource is really pulling together what I've created for our students in the past to develop something that's bringing them all together to create one thing for all students across New Zealand.
My goal was to bring these NZTC talents together on this important project and to see what we could create together.
From the start, it was from Ramasa's research online and that we wanted to create something that you can use in the classrooms and not just online.
And from there, it went to the design team where they made it so much more inviting, user-friendly as well, seeing the magic that they had done with the resource in terms of illustrations, colours. The vibrancy of the book is amazing.
When we first looked at the design, we looked at what was currently available, but we wanted to go somewhere different. We wanted it to be a little bit more than just a textbook.
We could see that there was going to be a huge potential for this book, you know, just refining it so that it's unique for the childhood sector. My contribution to the book involved some illustrations, sorting out fonts, figuring out how to lay out text.
We felt like it needed a bit more impact and a bit more colour, so I was brought on board to design some illustrations for it that would just bring the pages to life.
So the process of creating this resource involved many meetings between myself and design and Selena, just ensuring that we are creating something that's practical for the reader.
There was a lot of collaboration.
From design things to grammatical things.
From proofreading to signing it off to getting it from the printers to make sure that the colour's all correct.
Having external reviews done, more reviews, so it's been through a range of reviews, review, review, review.
Just lots of different elements from a lot of different people.
And then the end result, you know, just seeing everything on the page, we're really proud of what we've achieved.
A true reflection of whenaungatanga, where individuals and groups brought their skill sets and abilities and knowledge together, and eventually it created the whole book. It's a beautiful journey.
The magic of the book is that it contains real life, everyday words, phrases, waiata, all supported by images that bring the words to life, page after page.
The resource itself contains a range of different topics, different areas in terms of Māori language and early childhood education, ranging from the basics, from the alphabet, through to more complex phrases that students and teachers and families and children can learn along the way. One of the things that makes me proud as well in terms of the creation of the book is that it was written, designed and printed here in New Zealand. So it is New Zealand made, made in Aotearoa. Seeing the resource for the very, very first time, I had butterflies. You know, that feeling in your stomach when you're nervous but you're excited and you're proud and you're getting ready to do something so amazing, having that feeling, yeah, that sense, that feeling of butterflies.
When the books arrived, I was actually quite excited to see what it turned out, and when I got it in my hands, it was really amazing.
It's just amazing seeing a project like that come together.
Flicking through it, I was really excited about the potential of the resource and where it could go.
It'll change the attitude of practitioners to be more positive, where they're using reo more fluidly in their practice. As a result, it'll change the attitude of parents and children. So a trickle-on effect eventually will be building capacity for change.
When I first saw this book, I was just in love with it because of the beautiful colours and the pictures that are there and every resource that you need under the sun. When I brought the book out, the children just loved it and they were really happy to come and sit down and look at it, to turn the pages, look through it, and then we could discuss the different pictures that we saw and pronounce the different Māori words that were in it.
Any resource that is going to develop te reo Māori and the use of te reo Māori in an authentic way in a centre has got to be gold.
Next exciting steps are to now be gifting one to early childhood centres throughout New Zealand. It's an absolute honour to support our early childhood teachers and young children with their te reo Māori learning. As we all know, that these are the most influential language learning years. Well, success to me will be a tatty edge book with children and teachers' fingerprints all over it.
I think it would be great to see the book used successfully in early childhood centres.
With a teacher flipping through the books and folding it over and showing it to kids.
Not just by teachers, by children.
Teachers in their planning. Parents.
By whānau, by families.
I see no limits to this book at all. Anyone can use it and enjoy celebrating Te Reo Māori.
I wish I had it when I was training. It's beautiful.
That would be success for me.